Being young in the tech industry pays possibly the best. While there are many billionaires above the age of 50 and 60 in the tech industry, there are also dozens of freshly minted young billionaires. Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. For this video, we will discover Mark Zuckerberg, the youngest billionaire. But before anything else, please leave a like on the video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell down below so you won't miss our videos. Without any further ado, let's hop on right to the video. Mark Zuckerberg was born in White Plains, New York on May 14, 1984 and grew up in nearby Dobbs Ferry. He came from a well-educated household and showed an early interest in computer programming. Zuckerberg invented SuckNet, a messaging application that he used as an inter-office communication system for his father's dental practice when he was 12 years old. His parents hired a computer programming tutor while he was still in high school and enrolled him in a prep school in New Hampshire because of his early signals of success. Zuckerberg enrolled at Harvard University after graduating from prep school. While Harvard University attracts a diverse student body, Mark Zuckerberg soon established himself as the campus's go-to computer programmer. He had already built two programs by his sophomore year, Course Match and Face Mash. Both programs were hugely popular, but the latter was eventually shut down by the university because it was deemed improper. Based on his popularity in school, Zuckerberg teamed up with friends to launch a social networking site that allowed Harvard students to connect. The site, named The Facebook, went live in June 2004 and was run by Zuckerberg out of his dorm room. After his sophomore year, Zuckerberg dropped out of college to focus full-time on what was then known as Facebook. By the end of 2004, the website had surpassed 1 million visitors. Many venture capital firms were drawn to Zuckerberg's explosive user growth, and he eventually relocated to Silicon Valley in 2005. Accel Partners invested $12.7 million in Facebook's first round of venture capital funding when the site was still solely open to Ivy League students. By the end of 2005, however, Facebook had expanded to include students from other schools, bringing the total number of users to 5.5 million. Since 2005, Facebook has attracted multiple purchase approaches from companies like Yahoo and Microsoft, has faced legal challenges, and has seen a significant expansion in its user base. Facebook revealed its first quarter earnings for 2021 on April 28, 2021. The corporation reported quarterly revenue of $26.17 billion, up 48% from the previous quarter, and exceeding analysts' expectations. Additionally, bigger earnings per share and net income are expected. The number of monthly active users, a key indicator, increased by 10% year over year to 2.85 billion. The corporation has a market capitalization of $932 billion as of January 30, 2020. Zuckerberg owns approximately 375 million Facebook shares and controls 60% of the company's voting power. Zuckerberg, who has a net worth of $119 billion as of May 2021, has joined the Giving Pledge, pledging to contribute at least half of his fortune to charitable organizations before he dies. He gave more than $100 million to save the Newark school system in New Jersey in 2010, for example. On December 1, 2015, Zuckerberg and Chan announced that they would donate 99% of their Facebook shares, worth $45 billion at the time, to the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative, a new health and education non-profit. The monies will be transferred throughout the course of their lives, not immediately. Rather than founding a charitable corporation to contribute the stock's value to, as Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, Larry Page, and Sergey Brin, and other billionaires have done, Zuckerberg and Chan opted for the limited liability business structure. The Chan Zuckerberg Initiative, according to some journalists and academics, engages in philanthrocapitalism. The Chan Zuckerberg Initiative donated $600 million in 2016 to establish the Chan Zuckerberg Biohub, a tax-exempt collaborative research space in San Francisco's Mission Bay District near the University of California, San Francisco, with the goal of encouraging interaction and collaboration between scientists at UCSF, UC Berkeley, and Stanford University. Biohub and the Discoverer's Home Institution would share intellectual property developed. Unlike the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, which allows the public unrestricted access to and reuse of all its research it funds, Biohub retains the right to market any research it finances. With Biohub's authorization, inventors will be able to make their discoveries open source. Chan Zuckerberg wants to make scientific research more accessible and encourage open science. Biohub's investigators and staff scientists are required to post submitted publications and supporting data on preprint services like BioOre XIV. During the COVID-19 outbreak, Zuckerberg donated $25 million to a Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation-backed accelerator dedicated to finding cures. He also announced $25 million in grants to help local journalism affected by the pandemic, as well as $75 million in Facebook Inc. advertisement purchases in local newspapers where the company will market itself. Mark Zuckerberg is apart from everyone else's success. By bringing together communities and voices of regular citizens, he has accomplished something that very few others have done. To transform the world in the way that Zuckerberg has, it needs determination, vision, and most crucially, discipline. That's it for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss out on any future content we'll produce for you guys. We're signing off now, but we'll be sure to catch you all in the next one.